When working with permutations, you should be comfortable working either in this notation, it's called array notation, or in cycle notation. And in answering these questions, find their inverses, and I added one, find beta inverse two, I'm going to do that, and find these products, you should feel comfortable figuring out and writing the answer in either notation as well. Since this is given in array notation, let's write our answers initially in array notation. The assumption here is the top row is the entire domain of the function. These things are functions. Functions, in this case, on the set of the first six positive integers. That set, this first six positive integers, that's not the group. The group is the collection of functions, the collections of permutations that are being composed. Permutations being one-to-one and onto functions from the set to itself, in this case, from the set of the first six positive numbers to itself. And so therefore, when you write out what the answers are in array notation, you want the first row to be the same. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in this case. I'm going to do beta inverse as well. Make its row, first row, the same thing. And then again, the idea with this notation is the second row is what each thing in the top row gets mapped to. Okay, it's not like matrices in linear algebra. You're not multiplying these in some sort of way that you do in linear algebra. Alpha maps 1 to 2. Its inverse has got to go the other way. It's got to map 2 back to 1. You can think of it, since the original function goes from top to bottom, you can think of the inverse as going from bottom to top. So alpha inverse maps 2 to 1, it maps 1 to 2. Since alpha maps 3 to itself, so does its inverse. Since alpha maps 4 to 5, going down, it maps 5 to 4. I can fill in a 4 here. Since alpha maps 5 to 4, alpha inverse maps 4 to 5. And alpha maps 6 to itself, so does its inverse. And lo and behold, maybe you could see that without writing it all out. That's the same as alpha. Alpha is its own inverse. You could also say that alpha squared, which doesn't literally mean alpha times alpha, even though we say squared. The product of alpha and alpha, which is not a literal product in the usual sense, it's a function composition, does equal the identity. The identity permutation is denoted by epsilon. It maps all six of these numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, to themselves. And that would also say the order of alpha is 2, if you were interested in that. If I was asking you what's the order of alpha, that's what you'd be able to say. Beta inverse is not beta. Since beta maps 1 to 6, again, this was not asked for in the book. It's an extra thing I'm adding here. Beta inverse maps 6 back to 1. So I'd put a 1 there. Since beta maps 2 to 1, beta inverse maps 1 to 2. Since beta maps 3 to 2, beta inverse goes the other way and maps 2 to 3. Beta maps 4 to itself, so does beta inverse. Beta maps 5 to 3, and therefore beta inverse maps 3 to 5. Beta maps 6 to 5, and therefore beta inverse maps 5 to 6. Okay, so if you were asked what beta inverse is, that's what it is. Let's go ahead and think about these with cycle notation as well. In cycle notation, what numbers are getting cycled? That's the idea of cycle notation. 1 and 2 are getting cycled, and 4 and 5 are getting cycled with alpha. So I could write 1, 2, 4, 5 into two separate cycles like that. And again, with this notation, especially when you think of it as a long cycle, you go from left to right in each individual cycle until you get to the end where you go back to the beginning. But these are only two cycles, so that's very short. 1 gets mapped to 2, and then 2 gets mapped back to 1. 4 gets mapped to 5, and then 5 gets mapped back to 4. Both of those happen with alpha, and therefore you can write it as this quote-unquote product. And since these cycles are disjoint, they have no numbers in common, they commute, I could have written it in the other order. In general, the composition, The quote-unquote product of permutations is not commutative. When the cycles are not disjoint, they're not going to commute in general. But when they are disjoint like this, they have no numbers in common in each cycle. They do commute. And as I also mentioned briefly last week, you could write each of those cycles in with alternative notation like this. Right? And there's a few more ways of writing that. They're all equivalent. Any one of them is a correct way to write it. If a permutation is a product of disjoint two cycles, then that permutation is going to have order two. There's a theorem that says when you write a permutation as a product of disjoint cycles, whether they be two cycles and or three cycles and or four cycles, in this case, they're all two cycles, the order of the permutation is the least common multiple of the lengths of the cycles. But these lengths are each two. Least common multiple of two and two is two. Alpha does have order two. Beta as a product of disjoint cycles. What's getting cycled? Well, let's start with one. One goes to six. Six goes back to five. Five goes to three, and then three goes to two, and then two goes back to one. Four stays fixed. I don't need to bother writing it in here. I mean, it doesn't hurt to write a one cycle like that. It doesn't hurt, but you don't need to. The assumption is if you don't write that, well, four gets mapped to itself because you don't see it in there. So we can write this permutation beta as one five cycle, or if we prefer, two disjoint cycles, one of which is a five cycle and one is a one cycle. The least common multiple of five and one is five. Beta has order five. I'm not going to check it with this notation, but it turns out that beta has order five. The cycle notation is the easier way to see that. It's kind of cumbersome with the array notation. What's beta compose alpha and alpha compose beta? Beta alpha, rewrite them here. Here's beta, put it on the left. Alpha, put it on the right. Copying what they were before. Sorry that I put the five and six so close there. But it's function composition, so you've got to work from right to left. But the answer, if you write it in array notation, still has to be a permutation on the set of the first six positive integers. Think about it, each element at a time. Alpha maps one to two, but then beta maps two back to one. So ultimately, their product maps one to one. Alpha maps two to one, but then beta maps one to six. So ultimately their product maps two to six. Alpha maps three to itself, but then beta maps three to two. Alpha maps four to five, but then beta maps five to three. Alpha maps five to four. Beta keeps four fixed. So in the end, we end up with a four there. And then finally, alpha maps six to six, but then beta maps it to five. Can we confirm this with the cycle notation? Here were the cycles again. Let's rewrite those. I also could have computed beta alpha as the cycle 16532, that's beta, composed with alpha, which is a product two disjoint two cycles. That's a product of three non-disjoint cycles. There's common numbers. You would not compute the order of this by doing the least common multiple of two and five here. 10 is not going to be the order of this because they're not disjoint. But if you're going to think of it this way, how would you do it? Again, think about it one at a time. Start with the number one. Assume that maps one to itself because you don't see a one. but then one gets mapped to two, and two gets mapped back to one. Ah, matching that. So go to two, two is ultimately going to get mapped to six. I'll write it down. Two gets mapped to itself, but then to one, and then one gets mapped to six. So ultimately two gets mapped to six. Six gets mapped to itself, still to itself, but then to five, just like you see up here. Next one should be a four. Five should get mapped to four. Here it gets mapped to four right away. Then in these two, there's no fours. Four gets mapped to itself, four gets mapped to itself. So ultimately five does get mapped to four. Four gets mapped to five, which stays fixed, which then gets mapped to three. Three stays fixed, then gets mapped to two. It's going to cycle back to the beginning, and we already saw that one gets mapped to itself. So we did confirm the answer. And this does show that beta alpha is a five cycle, it turns out. And it would have order five. I won't bother doing alpha beta. Well, maybe we should in cycle notation at least. Let's do alpha beta in cycle notation. So I'm just switching around the orders of these things. Here and here. Switching around the order. In general, permutation composition is not commutative. So I should not expect to get the same answer here unless they happen to be disjoint cycles. But they're not. So I should not expect to get the same answer. I'll do it as quick as I can. Sorry about the mess up here. I meant this to be a curly brace. One gets mapped to six, which stays fixed. So right away, you can see it's already different. In this one, one got mapped to itself. In this one, one is getting mapped to six. Six gets mapped to five, which gets mapped to four. Four gets mapped to itself, which gets mapped to five. Then five gets mapped to three, which gets mapped to itself. Three gets mapped to two, which gets mapped back to one. And evidently, two stays fixed. Two gets mapped first to one, but then back to itself. Okay, and you can see those are not the same in terms of their mappings. Again, an individual permutation could be written in different ways, but you can see right away, for example, in this first one, one gets mapped to itself, but in the second one, one gets mapped to six, so they are different.